Okay, the best I can explain data notebooks is to show you some of the binders and notebooks that we've started here at Lake Myra. First of all, what I did as the IRT is I prepared digging deeper notebooks for all the teachers that were specific to each grade level. So for example, I created one of these notebooks for every second grade teacher, and it has all the digging deeper assessments in here that are all second grade digging deeper assessments, which is at the point you realize that a child is going to need interventions, you need to administer the digging deeper assessments to find out what is the child's most foundational area of need and which intervention you're going to do and which and how you're going to progress monitor the intervention. So inside this digging deeper assessments notebook is all of the digging deeper assessment information. So for example, inside sheet protectors, what I did was I made photocopies of the high frequency word list. There's like 20 in there. They're masters. All the teacher has to do is pull one out and administer it to a child. Here's the past. All of the past is in here. The task cards I put on rings so the teacher could know what to say to the child. And the marking sheets are here. And the two or three chips that the child needs are also at the bottom inside the sheet protectors. And again, there's like 20 masters for the child, the teacher to pull from. There's the early names test, and then behind the early names test is all the recording sheets for the early names test. So all the teacher has to do is pull them out and administer them. I know all this information is on CMAP, but I feel like when it's at their fingertips, they're going to administer it more easily and get to it instead of having to go to the CMAP and try and pull it off every single time. Now, the other type of data notebook that teachers have started is this one right here. This is a teacher, a second grade teacher, that is her classroom binder. It's called the Otter Talk and Progress Monitoring Binder, and inside this binder, she has all the kids that she's administering interventions with and progress monitoring. Now, you ask about AIMSWeb and say, if everything's on AIMSWeb, why do we need to keep it anyplace else? This is the form that we created at Lake Myra that has all the digging deeper assessments, all the digging deeper assessment data in here in foundational order. Now, all of this information, the intervention, the aim line, and the data points of how the child did on the intervention, this section is all in AIMSWeb. But this data right here, all the digging deeper assessment data, is not in AIMSWeb. So you're going to have to keep that information somewhere, including the kind of like the documentation of the intervention, which she keeps behind each child's name. So for example, this particular child, Emily, is getting an intervention in fluency, which was found to be her most foundational area of need. And she will be reading connected text with Ms. Reynolds, will be using the intervention strategies of fluency passages and phrases repeated readings in a group of five other students 4 days a week for 5 minutes per session. Here you can see that her progress was dipping down for two weeks in a row. So you can see here she changed the intervention because what she was doing wasn't working. Here you can see the evidence of her passages not working because she goes 48, 49, 55, 52, and that's in reverse order. So all of her digging deeper assessment data is here, but then the teacher decides to change the intervention, and instead she's going to be working on phonics, working on vowels, and using nonsense word cards. And so here you can see on the first week she's here, and then she's here, but all the meanwhile she's above her aim line. So whatever intervention she's doing here is working, and the teacher did not redo the digging deeper assessments after 3 weeks of the intervention not working. Here you can see where the child is tracking her own progress of nonsense word sounds and seeing her own growth. And then here's the Friday progress monitoring sheets that she's doing. Again, these are in reverse chronological order. So her most recent score was 71. The week before that it was 67. The week before that was 51. The week before that it was 42. Now, all of this progress monitoring data is from AIMSWeb, but this is the hard data. This is the evidence of it, and this is the evidence of the intervention of the digging deeper assessments that were used to determine which intervention and progress monitoring probe to try. The one last type of quote-unquote data notebook that we keep is this is a grade level binder. And what this is the second grade calendar and class information for all the kids in second grade. And this really takes into account the whole Our Kids philosophy, because what this team has done is they've taken all the steps of RTI For example, we say that if a child appears in kid talk 3 times in a row and they're still not making progress, that it's time to start otter talk. Otter talk is that form over here where you begin administering the digging deeper assessments. Once you do the intervention for 3 weeks, then if the intervention's not working, then we call in the case manager and try the intervention again for 3 more weeks. But as you can see on this list, that these are all of the children from Ms. Kimball's class. And every time that child hits a milestone in the RTI process, we document with dates that that child is going through that step. So all the children's name in the whole class are listed here. All this means is that these children are not below grade level. They're not missing any. They're not getting interventions because they don't need any interventions. And so the second grade team has one of these sheets for every single class in second grade. So this really ensures that no child will fall through the cracks. So I hope this kind of helps explain some of the data notebooks that we keep here at Lake Myra. And if you need any help or assistance or questions about that, feel free to call me or email me, JJones2.